again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Second and nine now from the 21. Out of the gun, Trubisky. This is caught by Robinson. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Trubisky will throw. Finds his target, Montgomery. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Now Trubisky looking middle, and it's incomplete. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now Trubisky to throw. And he's into the clear. The 20. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Sack lunch.
Back to the air, Trubisky after the pick six. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's going to get a good gain of nine here up to the 34.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
This one into the hands of Burton. And oh, he coughed it up, and it's picked up by the Chiefs. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line.
All right, you've had to put up with me in this booth. I'm going to try and be simple this time and succinct. It simply has not been their night.
No, I think that fumble's kind of indicative of how this whole evening's gone, isn't it?
Without a doubt. I mean, they've tried, but nothing has ever really taken throughout the game. That's why they're down so big.
So make some room next to Tom Dempsey on the NFL's all-time field goal distance leaderboard. That's going to go down officially as a 63-yarder.
Let's not forget about David Akers, Jason Elam, and Sebastian Janikowski, too. So now Matt Prater at 64 has got a little bit of company up near the top spot. That was one heck of a kick right there.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like that? Now Robinson coughs up the football. It's loose, and it's picked up by the Chiefs. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. And I don't know that fumble is going to matter a whole lot. You look at the deficit here in the fourth, it doesn't matter. The coach on the sideline still scratching his head.
Yeah, not only scratching his head, but probably writing a note or two about, we're going to address this come practice next week because maybe that's the reason we're down this far. Does it matter?
Looking to throw again on second down. Trubisky, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. After that sack we just saw, Trubisky and the Bears deal with a third and long. One last shot for Trubisky. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. So this one in the win column for Kansas City, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I'll bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense it was much more of the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got it together, got a spark, and then took off. It's really nice to watch in the second half.
So for Kansas City, it's a big win here as they move to 11-4 now on the year. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Bears, they'll be guaranteed a finish of no better than 500 as they drop to 7-8. And they'll be off to Minneapolis next week for a look at new U.S. Bank Stadium and a date with the Vikings. And for Charles Davis and our... Start your week by installing your game plan.
Big Snoop Dogg, it's in the game.
S-T-R-O.
Yeah. How many of y'all came to win?
Oh, they asked you my name, huh? You ready?
S-T-R-O, I ain't come to play with you.
Yeah.
Life challenging, but I wouldn't trade with you.
Trade.
It's early, I'm up.
Yeah.
I can't spend the day with you. I'm minding my business. I ain't getting paid with you.
Nope.
My color bright.
Yeah.
I ain't finna fade with you. Man, I gotta come clean like I made with you.
Clean.
I been on my everybody drop when I drop.
Yeah.
Look at shorty, she support, bruh. Lifting up, never not on my grind. New York City time. Another brother better, you will never find. I've been in my bag like groceries. Competition shouldn't take shots, take notes, please.
Yeah, yeah,
Reporting live from the winner's side. Ready, try, keep a different vibe. Cause you down the ride, never tie. You will never know, you ain't never tried. Work it out, hit the gym, hit the field.
Yeah,
hey, yo, I need that. Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard, on the job, you can see that. On my heat bag, they clear the way with my crew coming through. What I do? Lace up the shoes, chase the breeze.
What I do?
Lace up the shoes, chase the breeze.
Now what I do?
Lace up the shoes, chase the breeze.
Yeah.
The beats, leave it in the street. Case on the news.
What I do? Lace up my shoes, chase W's. Great colored coupes. Oh no, no, I can't be number two. MVP the league, most valuable. They sweet as apple juice. Talking trophies, I didn't grab the few. Can't match this attitude. I wear my heart on my sleeve, please. I move like the wind, can't catch this breeze, freeze. Stop you in your tracks, there's not no preseason. We seeking W.
Coach, some might say it's cold. Others, like myself and my partner, we say this is football weather as we welcome you to chilly M&T Bank Stadium near the Inner Harbor in Baltimore. Today, the curtain falls on the regular season, and we've got a good one in store between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Baltimore Ravens. The Steelers make their way out. The Killer Bees are no more. Only one remains, and that's their quarterback, number 7, Ben Roethlisberger.
Block 80!
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And here we go again. Here we go again.
This is a guy who made a Pro Bowl in his second season, James Conner. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. On 2nd down, Connor looking for space. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. 3 and out, a real danger here on their opening drive as they come up on a 3rd and 12. Now Roethlisberger. That went into the hands of his tailback, Samuels. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to make it 4th down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Barry on to punt as he gets this one away. Fielded at about the 28. So dangerous with a football in his hands. Call that a return of 38. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 8 carries, 76 yards, and a touchdown.
And they've already clinched a playoff berth, so I'm eager to see how they approach this game, because some teams' philosophy is to go ahead and get guys out. Other teams' philosophy, continue to do what you're doing best. I expect them to go ahead and use their top guys all the way.
And he'll get in! Touchdown, Baltimore! A great effort there. Touchdown number 15 of the year. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the side.
Let's go, B. It's going to be a long day, offense. It's going to be a long day. Black and burn.
Play fake to Connor. Now Roethlisberger going top shelf for Smith. Into a double team and it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk Earl Thomas. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.